In recent years, Microsoft released a lot of cool new features that improves your PowerPoint experience. I mean, check out that morph effect. But aside from that, they solved a lot of pain points that we were previously fixing with the help of add-ins. Now, there are still a lot of great free add-ins out there that many people aren't aware of. Let's check them out. First of all, how do you install an add-in? You open PowerPoint, go to Insert, Add-ins, Get Add-ins. Then you can browse by the different categories or search what you're looking for and then just click on Add. The first one that I want to show you is called Pro Word Cloud. This gives you a visual representation of text data. So words that appear more frequently in your text are going to be bigger and bolder. This way you can easily spot trends when you're dealing with a lot of text. To install it, you just have to type Pro Word Cloud. That's the one we want, and then click on Add and Continue. Now, if you've already installed an add-in, you can easily find it if you go back to Add-ins, My Add-ins, click on this drop-down, and you're going to see it right here. So I've already installed that. I'm just going to click on this, and the side pane opens here. Now I can select the font that I want for my word cloud, the different color scheme that I'd like, layout, maximum words, and so on, and then click on Create Word Cloud. Now, obviously, I don't want to create a word cloud based on this, but on this slide, I have some feedback that I've collected from multiple students, and I want to analyze this so that I can easily see what phrases or words the students have mentioned. To generate a word cloud based on this, I just have to highlight the text and create the word cloud. This analyzes the text and creates a visual for me. If you don't like the effect, you can update the settings here. So let's go with Arial, and for the color scheme, let's go with something lighter. I'll go with sky, and with the text highlighted, I'm going to regenerate the word cloud. To copy this, I just have to click on it, and it tells me the image has been copied to your clipboard. Now let's go to an empty slide, and let's use Control V to paste this in, and I get my word cloud as an image. And if you have Office 365 and you have the designer on the side, you can change the layout of this and make it a little bit fancier. Next free add-in is called Break Time. Sometimes you need to give presentations that go over many hours, and you're going to want to add breaks in there. Attention is precious, and attention needs breaks. But the problem is sometimes the people don't come back on time. A good way to keep everyone on the same page is to embed a timer directly into your PowerPoint presentation. To get this add-in, go to Office Add-ins, look for Break Time, and add this in. You can then adjust the size and position of this, just like with any other object. Down here, you can select the minutes and the seconds. So let's just update this to 5, and you can decide on the theme that you want. None is this minimalistic look that we have. Let's say I want a coffee break. I'm going to add this in. And I can expand this to fit my slide or just to blend it in to my existing slide. Now, whenever you want to run this, just click on Start. It runs whether you're in edit mode or in presentation mode. This way you can set a timer to complete an exercise, an assigned reading, or use it as a countdown before the start or end of the session. Next one is called QR for Office. Let's say at the end of your presentation, you want to leave a contact to your website or social media or the download link for the presentation materials. Of course, you can show the URL just like this and trust that the audience manages to write it down correctly. Or you make it easier for them and include a QR code that's going to take them directly to your links page or your website page. All they have to do is use the camera on their phones. With an add-in called QR for Office, you can easily generate such QR codes. Now, I've already downloaded this, so I'm going to go to My Add-ins and grab it from here. All you have to do is type the URL that you want, adjust the color, background, and the size that you want, and then click on Insert, and then you can place it wherever you want on your slide. Next up is Mentimeter. So often online meetings can get boring and your audience can start dozing off. If you don't want that to happen to your presentation, you can use Mentimeter. It allows you to create interactive polls and quizzes and even word clouds in real time. It's a great icebreaker for any presentation. All you need to do is sign up for a free account on Mentimeter.com. Then you can, among other things, generate word clouds. You can have your audience choose between or even rank different options. and you can have them post questions that you can answer live. Now, once you save your presentation, you can share it with a temporary voting code. The voting activates when you start presenting. Now, I have a complete video on this, and I'm going to add the link to the description of this video. So if you want to learn how you can set up these type of polls from scratch, make sure you check out that video. Now, the reason we have it in our PowerPoint add-ins is that Mentimeter has a free add-in for PowerPoint. All we have to do is go and grab it. It's right here, click on add and continue. Now you're going to need to log in with the same account that you created, and then you just have to add the link of the slide that you want to embed in your PowerPoint. To get that link, we're going to go back to Mentimeter. I'm going to go to my presentations. This is one of the presentations that I want to embed. That's the slide I want to embed. I want to ask my audience what they're most confident in. Let's go to presentation mode. Go to the URL box here and copy this. Now let's just go back and paste this in and click on select. This is going to directly embed it on my slide. And just like any object, I can position this as I need. Now I'm going to go to presentation mode and I'm going to tell my audience, go to menti.com and use this code. They're going to bring up their phones, type the URL and type the code. Once they type in the code on their phone, they're going to see this slide and then they can interact with this. So let's just add in some scores here and click on submit. The moment we do that, we can see this presentation update. Each slide has a unique link, so if you want more interactive slides, you need to repeat the process. If you want to delete a Mentimeter slide, click on your visual, select this tiny arrow on the top, and then select delete. Next one is Thor, the hammer. So the final add-in that I'd like to show you is from a fellow Microsoft MVP colleague, Steve Rinsberg. The add-in isn't available in the Office store, but you can download it from Steve's website, pptools.com. Thor has a very simple purpose. It lets you position any shape to a fixed position and size. It's easier explained if I just show you. So you can download it for free from here. Then just close PowerPoint, install it, and then open PowerPoint up again, and you're going to see a new tab under ribbon called PP Tools. So here on this presentation, I'm planning to have different images, but I want all of these placed properly, and I want them to be placed on this corner here, and they should all have the same size. Now, instead of doing this manually for every single slide, and let's assume I have more slides, it's just going to take up a lot of my time. What I can do is use the Thor add-in. This memorizes the size and position of an object and then hammers it down on all the other objects. It's a super simple add-in. First, just check your options. You can decide on your alignment, whether you want the object to be resized or not, whether it should be distorted or not. So I'm going to put don't distort here and then click on OK. This is the position I want the other objects to be in, so I'm going to click on it and select memorize. Now I'm going to go to the next object, select it, and hammer this down. It's going to put it in the exact same position as my first object. Then go to the next one and hammer it down as well. Now, in case you also want an image to fill up the slide, what you can do is click on the side of the slide and then go to memorize and click on OK for memorizing the slide size. Now you can adjust your options here in case you don't mind the object being distorted. I'm going to uncheck don't distort, click on OK, and then select my object and hammer this down. It's going to fill up my slide automatically. Now Thor's memory holds one object at a time, but if the type of slides that you make include a lot of images, this is really going to speed up your work. Before we wrap this up, I have a productivity tip for you. If you use your add-ins frequently, you can add these add-ins to your quick access toolbar. Now I'm just going to right mouse click to show my quick access toolbar. Then let's go ahead, right mouse click and customize our quick access toolbar. Now, if you just click on this drop down and go to the insert tab, you're going to be able to locate your add-ins. Scroll down until you see my add-ins and add it to your quick access toolbar. Click on OK. Now, every time you want to use one of your add-ins, just click on this drop down and they're going to be available right here. Okay, so those are some add-ins that I liked. Are there any PowerPoint add-ins that you're currently using and you'd recommend to others? Please share these with us in the comments. So do give this video a thumbs up if you liked it. Do consider subscribing if you aren't subscribed. And I'm going to see you in the next video.